We're going to take the grease and we're going to run it starting at the top all the way down. And we're going to get it all the brake cable. Like so. We're going to start to pass it through, like so. Come through, pass through, like so. Now, we can come around the back side like this. And we're going to come through here and we have little clips. And that's actually what we're going to be doing. Clipping this to here. So I'm first feeding it.
You can see here, here's the whole bike run.
I'm now coming back to the back, feeding that there, like so. I gotta grab a small screwdriver. Like this. I'm gonna pop these clips off. Like this. Clips like that. By the way, our hands are a mess. It's okay. Spinning our bike around a little bit. Popping all the clips off. Front clip. And these ones underneath the frame here. So there you go. I want to do it. If you wanted to make this cable a little bit shorter, you really could. You could pull this side here out, which I think what we're going to do. Like so. I'm going to cut off about 3 inches of cable just because I don't like the amount of cable we have for this. That's what we've cut off with a brake cable. Housing, not the brake cable itself. now take this. One thing. Once you cut these, take a little pick, make a little piece. Something like a tool like this. I'll open that up. Okay, there we go. That through. More than enough play. Okay, so once again, we're gonna take this cable here, we're gonna take our third hand tool. I always start and go as far as I can up here. Grab our five. Clamp that down tight. Third hand tool
as you goes crashing to the ground.
And we got the cable set. So now that guy. And now that guy. Okay. So this is gonna have to get cut obviously. But that should be good for now. Okay, so next up, we got our brakes on, cables wise. The next thing we want to do is do the rest of our cables. Okay. So, the first thing
we want to do is we got more little cable runs that we have.
Sorry here. So we got all our little cable runs here. And now we just gotta figure out where everything goes. So we had a blank spot. We have a cable run that goes from here to here. So that's probably gonna be. It's not going to be this piece. This middle piece to so that's going to be there. I believe. This one. Go around. Back. Like so. You have a small piece here. It's going to come here. And then this here. Probably. I'm guessing going to be there like that. And then these guys are going to go up front. So, once again, we're going to start by greasing. The only reason for the grease, and I don't do this everywhere, is just because of where we're at location-wise in the world. The grease will prevent from rusting as well as prevent from all other issues that we might encounter. Okay, so one thing I'm going to do first before we go any farther. Put in our block in the back. Put our chain on. Question is, perfectly.
Oh, there's that.
Sorry, folks. We got our cable cut, our cable run here for this guy. Thank you. just a little bit of tension on it. Okay, now the next thing that we really need to do is we're going to have to size up our chain. Of course, this chain ring is quite a bit smaller than this guy for the Suntour. And then, of course, our cable. This one. One more cable right here. Once again, get our grease. That should be it for grease for today. Now the only issue with grease, with greasing your cables, is that they can cause, if they're not completely internally grounded, maybe a little bit of dirt buildup in certain portions. For the most part, I'm not really worried about that. Now the one thing you want to make sure is that I'm actually having to cross the cables. So this guy over here is for our three. Okay. this is gonna come down here for our front derailleur. That's that. Okay, so cables are through. Here, we got all our cables up front done. And the next thing we're gonna do, one thing too, you know, like I said, we got our grips. Looks like they're gonna fit with our bar ends. I always ride with bar ends. Okay, so we got our cables done, or pushed through the trick now. The fact that I'm not familiar with how this front derailleur works. Levers, rear derailleur, just the rear derailleur. Great. Nothing for the setup for the front derailleur. So what I'm going to do is I'll be back. We're going to kind of put this part of the video on pause, so I have to figure out. It's not going to pull that way. It's got to pull. I think if this came up from the bottom, reality, you can use the old
original
derailleur. The old derailleur.